Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're watching us from around the world. This is the European Continental Cup live from Helsinki here in Finland. Getting ready for game one. My name is Sven. I'm sitting here with Riggs. And just out of camera, we have got Loud and Clear, who's going to be slinging the stats and making sure basically we talk about what we're supposed to be talking about and don't go off on tangents. So as we said, it's European Continental Cup and game one is going to see us here with Dublin Roller Derby, skating out Dublin, Ireland, of course, coming into the tournament. Seed number one, currently ranked 31 in WFTDA.
Oh, yes.
And they're going to be taking on the number 8 seed in the tournament, Antwerp Roller Derby, obviously skating out of Antwerp in Belgium. They're coming in, say, number 8 seed, number 65 in WFTDA. So we're going to go through some team rosters now. So I will start off with the Dublin roster. So Dublin are going to be skating in the blue today. So we're going to be seeing them. So we'll see 05, Vegan Fox, 123, Maria Von Slap, 169, Brood Ollie Lowcock, 17 is Dirty Lees, Dirty Knees Louise, number 23 is Greenhall Cooney, number 3, Valdemort, 47 is AK, 490 is Malibu Stacey, 53 is RG Bargy, 575 Pippa, 74 is Stabber, number 8 is Chancletta. Number 83 is Dash and Trudy Snow. Number 90 is Lana Payne. And number 95, Mania. So, Riggs, if you can give us Antwerp Roller Derby.
I will do Antwerp Roller Derby, who will be playing in pink today. We have 07, Cherry Mosh Pit. 10, Margin Boo. Number 13, Evil X. Number 2, Freckles. Number 250, Nick Mops. Number 357, Dark Pistol. Number 375, Two Face Grace. Number 5, Wildcard. Number 50, Snow Black. Number 6, Queen Yosin. Number 85, CC Titmouse. Number 89, Hipshot. Number 9, Gunter. Number 91, Lieutenant Savage. And 93, Dr. G. That is Antwerp Roller Derby, or your One Love Roller Dolls, who will be playing in pink today.
And well, we've got a minute before the game starts. We'll just run down the officials crew that we've got today, making sure that everything here is done to the rules of the WFTDA. We've got Pretty Miffed, Connie, Restless Bitchface, Speedy Convalesce, Festa, Kaiser Guez, Luna Kasanen, Strange Edge, Liz Frizzle, Mimi First, and we've got Baff, Genuine, Major Buzzkill, Victoria Velociraptor, Caps Lock, Daniel Rario, and Total Miscall. And they're going to be our officials for the day. We've got about 1 minute left before the start here of game one, as we said, of the European Continental Cup here in Helsinki. Brought to you, of course, by our hosts, Kallio Rolling Rainbow and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. So some things just to obviously look at before we go in. So we read through the rosters there. Just want to send some love back home to Dublin on behalf of us here and on behalf of all the fans, on behalf of Dublin themselves, of course, to Gemerald and Thea, who unfortunately couldn't be here for the tournament through a few reasons. But you may see that Dublin are, of course, showing the support now, with several of the players wearing number 800 and number 16 dotted around their bodies in marker pen. So you'll see that. And so obviously big love from us, big love from the team. Bob came across and asked me just to make sure that everyone at home understands how much of a miss they're going to be on the benches here. And we'll see how much of a miss they're going to be in the gameplay in just 10 seconds.
So on the line, ready to go. We've got number 89 for Antwerp at Hipshot going up against number 83, Dashing Trudy Snow for Dublin. And the packs come right back from the get-go behind the jam line. That lane opened up beautifully there for Dublin, taking lead up the inside. Hipshot though, only about half a lap behind.
Quick call off there by Dash and Trudy Snow in. Picks up 2 for Dublin, so on the board in the first jam, 2-0 in favour of Dublin after that quite quick jam, 30 seconds or so.
As we go into the second jam, Antwerp with 2 in the box, so pack deficit for them as they start the second jam. And that's number 23. That's Greenhall Cooney out there for Dublin, going up against number 13, Evil X for Antwerp. That's 1 apiece now. Oh no, it's like 2 in a row, sorry, there for Dublin. That pack advantage really helping them out.
Evil X is through. They're now half a lap behind. But once again, Dublin with a quick call-off picks up the 4 points, calls off the jam.
That's a lovely pirouette right at the end of the exit of the pack there from number 23, Green Holcooney there.
And we are going to be going in again, slightly smaller pack now. It looks like, I think that's Cherry Mosh, but we've got standing in the box ready to come out. So it brings us back to 3-on-3. But right now at the very start of the jam, it's 3-on-2 in favour of Dublin. Hip shot. Lining up for Antwerp, just managing to step through the inside. Looks like got one to beat. Picks up lead for Dublin, for Antwerp.
AK at the back of that Antwerp pack, removes the star now, looking for some relief, but it is a dummy star pass. So AK continues to fight on, but Antwerp wise to that situation and the star stash not helping right now as Hipshot collects the first 4 points.
Lana Payne is at the front of the pack with a pivot stripe on, but is doing more blocking at the moment. Just trying to get in the way of Hipshot, who rolls around the outside of turn two for another scoring trip on the pack.
AK still being held by Antwerp just at the exit of turn two, and there is a cover on the floor. It has been retrieved now, and AK continues to battle on, but Antwerp with a full pack on track are doing an excellent job of containing AK right now as we see Hipshot coming back in. Oh, nearly went for a little ride with a Dublin blocker there.
Yeah, it was a great hit from Valdemort there, but Hipshot managed to hold the composure and stay upright. Now just being taken all the way back by Pippa, back to the penalty box straight.
AK was locked down there at the entrance to the turn three, but we have a star pass now, and that is number 90. That is Lana Payne, who finally exits the Antwerp pack with after a minute and a half. So that was a great jam there from Antwerp, able to contain. They picked up, it looks like 12 points to me in that jam. So not only have they covered the 6 points that Dublin have picked up, but they have now put themselves in the lead and they are 6 points ahead. So a fantastic third jam from Antwerp there. And Dublin with two in the box as we start this next jam.
And it looks like going to be going with Vegan Fox for Dublin as the jammer against Evil X for Antwerp.
A wild card hit to the outside as Antwerp pick up lead. And that is Evil X, who is coming in now on a scoring pass. Oh, great lines picked there. That was beautiful from Evil X, just picking a lovely line and riding out the hits. But look at this containment, Sven, from Antwerp yet again.
Yeah, and Evil X isn't having to work here to get through. The pack work, as you're saying there, from Antwerp is brilliant. But now we've got Vegan Foxes through for Dublin, finally out on the initial pass.
Antwerp rushing in with the offense there, just to clear that for Evil X and grabbing them 3 points at the end of that jam. So scores. And Antwerp in two jams have put up 27 points.
I'm going to go with Dash and Trudy Snow against Queen Yassine.
And Dublin have the pack advantage as this jam opens up. Oh, great catch and contain from the line this time.
Much slower, but Queen Yassine is able to get round Lana Payne, picks up lead for Antwerp. Dashing through Snow now with star in hand, trying to find a way up the inside. Queen Yassine takes that route, again manages to skip over Lana Payne, and looks like we're getting a low block call on Lana Payne for that block against Antwerp.
So Dublin took lead in the first two jams, but Antwerp have taken it in the next three, and it is a star pass now for Dublin to force that jam to an end. That was 169 who took that. That is Brudol E. Locock. Was able to bring that jam to an end for Dublin, but another 7 points picked up by Antwerp. So those three jams have had a big impact on the scoreline already. Just to clarify, in jam three, it was My apologies, my maths this early this morning, not so great. But Evil X is out there for Antwerp right now. Going up against Greenhall Cooney.
Greenhall Cooney makes the initial moves to the outside, switches to the inside of turn one, gets railroaded off the track. And it looks like, it's a forearms penalty to Greenhall Cooney. So Antwerp now able to capitalize on that jammer penalty. Evil X now picks up lead. And Antwerp now on the power jam. Let's see what they can do with this, Riggs.
Well, it's not looking good for my bracket right now. If this game continues in this way, I don't know how you guys at home are feeling about your bracket challenge, but Antwerp have arrived and they are awake right now and they are giving Dublin a time of things. But this penalty kill is going incredibly well right now. And in fact, that is the penalty killed right there. Great work from Dublin.
Greenhall Cooney back to the track now, star in hand. Just going up the inside now, trying to move to the outside, trying to switch through inside turn three. As we get, I think it's a forearms penalty being called now again on Greenhall Cooney, so we're back to the power jam for Antwerp.
But Dublin blockers doing an incredible job there of killing the penalty and even the second one right at the end of the jam. So it is going to be a power jam start for Antwerp as we go into this next jam. And I believe they've held Dublin scoreless for quite a number of jams now. In fact, since the second jam, I believe, Dublin unable to pick. So it is four scoreless jams for Dublin right now as we go into this next one. And we've got Greenhall Cooney out there for Dublin. But your lead jammer right now is Hip Shot for Antwerp. So this is the first power jam start of the game. And Antwerp looking to make this count with four on the board already.
Greenhall Cooney now leaves the box. Got half a lap to catch the pack. Meanwhile, Hipshot has been recycled back to turn one by Brutally Lowcock.
That Antwerp wall was waiting patiently at the exit of turn two, but Greenhall Cooney just came through and found some gorgeous room on the outside to get on through, but they lock back down at turn three. Greenhall dodges one more blocker to get on out.
That was some matrix-like toe-stop balance there from Greenhall Cooney to hold that line. But Antwerp in control just shuts down the jam now, opening up a 44-point lead over Dublin with less than 10 minutes played.
I didn't see this coming, Sven. I'm not going to lie.
I did not see this coming, but as we always know, you never underestimate any team in roller derby. If they've worked hard enough to get to this competition, then they're out for something. So
Loud and Queer with some excellent points just made. Of course, no team gets a bye in this tournament. Every team has the opportunity to take a medal home. That is a fact, as we see. Evil X, your lead jammer for Antwerp right now.
Vegan Fox now out and running for Dublin. Completed the initial pass.
Evil X, though, eyes on the Dublin jammer at all times and calls it. But not in time to hold Dublin out. 2 points picked up there. That was great work by Dublin just to sneak those in at the end.
So we'll give a shout out now to Rydell Skates, the proud sponsor of the 2019 WFTDA Playoffs and Championships.
Hip Shot on the line for Antwerp going up against AK for Dublin. Dublin with the pack advantage as Antwerp have one in the box, and AK uses that pack deficit to their advantage to get on through. First lead for Dublin since jam two. Can they keep Antwerp scoreless? They do. They do hold Antwerp scoreless and pick up 3 points in the process.
So we mentioned at the start you know, in the run-up to the game, the lead into the game, that obviously Dublin are missing Gemerald and Thea here. And obviously Thea and Gemerald, both two of Dublin's biggest jammers throughout the regular season. So we're seeing a few more of the jammers who maybe, like, say, AK there, who jammed during the regular season, but not much. And obviously Vegan Fox, who we didn't, I don't think we've even seen Vegan Fox in the regular season playing now, coming into this tournament. So maybe we're just going to see them now having to readjust their style, missing those two big players in their roster, those two big jammers.
Absolutely. As we see Green Hall Cooney out for Dublin and picking up lead up against Queen Yosin for Antwerp right now. But I suppose the interesting thing is that Antwerp will have presumably had a little look at the established jammers of Dublin, so might not necessarily be prepared for the new types of jammers coming in that they wouldn't necessarily have seen. So it could still be a very interesting situation as Dublin put up four and hold Antwerp scoreless for a second jam in a row.
So we're going to get a hip shot for Antwerp next, who's been one of the main two jammers in the rotation for Antwerp against Dash and Trudy Snow. 4-on-3 advantage. Oh, Antwerp is hip shot. Takes that outside line and just managed to burst through for lead now. Antwerp trying to break down the last couple of jams that Dublin have had control with, control of their own.
And that was all thanks to a fantastic hit from Lieutenant Savage of Antwerp, who just took out Dashing Through the Snow and forced a reset. And back again, we see that is number 50 that this time. That's Snow Black.
That's
with the recycle.
Snow Black recycling Dash and Trudy Snow.
But picks up a penalty. So Antwerp with two in the box as we speak right now. Four on the board already for hip shot. The Dashing Through the Snow completes the initial and is now in a scoring position, which forces hip shot to call the jam. And Antwerp responding kind with holding Dublin scoreless in that jam. Just having a sneaky look at the penalties, and it looks like everything's good so far. Just a couple, although we've seen a bit of action in the box, it's nicely spread out amongst the team. Yeah, no one's on more than two penalties max for per player at the moment. So it's a lovely clean game. As you see, a very mixed pack off the line. Vegan Fox versus Evil X.
Evil X wins that race around the outside of turn one, picks up lead and for Vegan Fox has been reabsorbed at the pack. Has Marhin Boo to beat now. Just got to get past Dr. G and is out on the initial pass.
Oh, and Evil X tried to go straight through the middle there, and Dublin enacting the pinball machine and taking them down.
And good jammer instincts there from Evil X. Called off the jam while in the air from that hit.
I'm going down. I'm taking this jam with me.
Great awareness to know where the other jammer is and where you are, of course, in terms of scoring.
For those of you with an eagle eye, will have spotted Antwerp are running pretty much a two jammer rotation. Hipshot and Evil X are doing a lot of the work right now, but every now and again, Queen Yosin is in there, maybe as a relief jammer, but right now, AK is out of the pack and is your lead jammer for Dublin. Oh, and it is a power jam in favor of Dublin right now, as we see Evil X go to the box. And I think it was AK who was out last time there was a power jam in that situation as well. So AK, a little bit lucky right now for Dublin. But that's just... my apologies, it's hip shot in the box, not Evil X. They've only got two jammers out and I still can't get them right, but hip shot's out in there and standing as we speak. 8 points on the board already for Dublin in this jam.
Lana Payne going on the offense for AK and doing a good job releasing AK through for another 4 points as the power jam comes to an end. Hipshot returns to the track.
That toe stop work on the line combined with that upper body strength is a fantastic thing to watch. And AK with great awareness there picks up 4 points. and hold Antwerp scoreless.
Yeah, we can see VB there just gesticulating from the box exactly what he wanted AK to do, and AK took that command. Obviously, used the right decision just to get that timing right and get that jam called off. So Dublin now in the fight back, only 30 points apart, 31 to Dublin. Clears Antwerp 61, 13 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the period.
So Dublin doubled their score in that last jam. So huge jam there from AK. But we're back on track now with Greenhall Cooney and Evil X. And it is Greenhall Cooney who's looking for space on the outside, finds it with some beautiful pivot work, pirouetting work even. Pivot work for somebody else.
And we've got the Antwerp star currently on the ground, being now recovered. Evil X going to start the assault on the pack again as Greenhall Cooney gets up the inside of turn two. Star pass has happened to Boo for Antwerp.
Oh, and the pack speeds up for the first time today. I try to outrun the jammers. I've not seen this yet in the game.
Dublin just trying to control that pack speed, having only two blockers on the track. That's great work from them. Just to do that, to make Boo really work for those points and to catch the pack. Yeah, there was eight on the board a moment ago, it looked like, but then we saw the jam ref coming. I think essentially there was a single one pass, but it was somehow recorded twice. So obviously that was just corrected. So if you did see 8 points go for Dublin there, it has been corrected by the officials. It was, I think, a miscommunication, which has been sorted out now between the jam ref, the scorekeeper, and the scoreboard.
So a little quick shout out to one of our sponsors, Radar Wheels. Experience world-class edging with the number one wheel in Derby. Radar Halo.
So we're in a team timeout right now, called by Antwerp.
So looking at this game so far, we've had one power jam per team so far in this game, and I'm just having a nosy at the penalties. And again, they're not racking up for anybody right now. So both teams starting this weekend of Derby with some excellent play.
So it looks like Dublin are going to be lining up with Dash and Trudy Snow. And it is Queen Yassine, as we said, the kind of the third jammer that Antwerp have been running so far in the game. No pack advantage, but it is 3-on-3.
We should see a very defensive formation from the blockers right now, as we see them both packs of blockers just settling down. But Antwerp trying to play offense, so they've gone with a two wall to try and hold back dashing Trudy Snow. But this defense is fantastic. We've not even made it to the pivot line right now. The blockers are all over the jammers.
Yeah, right off the line we had Cherry Moshpit and I think it was Lieutenant Savage just holding up Dash and Tootie Snow. And even with that bit of offense that came from Stabber, from came out the box, not able to break down that three wall that's now sitting holding Dash and Tootie Snow at the back.
That was a beautiful two wall on display there from Antwerp. Just able to contain somehow Dash and Trudy Snow. But look at this Dublin tripod locking down on that back straight away.
So again, just after that timeout, we've had a switch up in the pace of the game and the way that this is played now. We've got two strong sets of blockers just holding these jammers in place.
So that's number nine in there. Gunter was trying to do the offense, but unfortunately it's a forearms call on Queen Yosin. So this is a power jam in favor of Dublin and Dash and Trudy Snow. So the offense comes in, and that is 5-7-5. Pippa, the captain, clearing a path for Dash and Trudy Snow to become your lead jammer.
Yeah, there was about a minute and 20 seconds before we had a lead call there, which just goes to show the way the pace of the game has changed. We'll see if Dublin now do anything with this. They are one blocker down right now. dashing through the snow, just takes the choice to call the jam off. Queen Yassine standing in the box, so they're going to have that power start just for a few seconds, though. But because of the setup here of the track, where the penalty box is on the opposite side of the jam, like the jam line straight, you know, you've got a few extra seconds of power start from when Queen Yassine gets released. And we have a last minute change out, and we're going to have Greenhall Cooney lining up in that power start position for Dublin. Queen Yassine released from the box now, got half a lap to catch up with the pack.
The tactical awareness of both teams so far has been fantastic, able to change and adapt to what is being put in front of them. But we've got a star pass right now for Antwerp. That is number 10, Ajimbu, who has taken the star. But in the pack right now, Greenhawk only looks to take the whip, finds the momentum to get around the outside, pick up the four, and calls it perfectly to shut out Antwerp.
So 20-point differential, Dublin trailing by the 20.
So we see Hipshot taking the line up against Vegan Fox, and Antwerp have been held scoreless by Dublin for the last four jams. So the momentum of this game is shifting brilliantly, but there is one each in the box, and the three walls can't contain Hipshot as room is found on the outside. But Vegan Fox only half a lap behind and puts on the burners to try and get through and minimize the damage that can be done by Hipshot, but great inside line work.
Antwerp are doing a great job of every time Dublin look like they're getting back into it and getting the momentum to swing in their favour. They just managed to pull out a jam like that, get the momentum back, get some points up, and again, just kind of take a bit of the wind out of Dublin's sails. And we're going to see AK on the line now for Dublin against Evil X.
And Dublin with two blockers in the box right now, so leaving them with quite the pack deficit. Antwerp with three on track, and Evil decides to go straight through their wall to try and confuse the blockers. But look at AK picking up lead, even with that pack deficit against them. But Evil is out of the pack at the exit of turn two. But AK's through, picked up the four.
AK just being told by the Dublin bench there just to run this a bit longer.
And they did, in fact, run the jam just long enough to clear the box. So 2 points picked up by Antwerp there, but for Dublin, it may well have been a worthy sacrifice to make sure that you start the next jam with a full complement of blockers. And they're hovering around the pivot line. Do they mean it? I have to say no. Nobody ever seems to mean a pivot line start these days. It's all lies. And see, look, there they come back to the jam line to meet Greenhall Cooney and Hipshot. Hipshot with some great strength to drive through the front of that pack to pick up lead for Antwerp. Oh, lovely line picked by Hipshot to go through for the four. And it looks like Dublin have passed off the star. It is Chankletta, who is now your jammer of record for Dublin. First star pass taken by Chankletta.
Hipshot, though, is able to find those paths through the inside of the turns for another scoring trip on the pack.
Big recycle there from the Antwerp pivot. That's number 50, Snow Black. Hipshot had no room and no business getting through on the outside there, but still does it anyway.
Antwerp finally have to let Chankletta out of the pack for Dublin's initial pass.
So big jam there, 14 points picked up by Antwerp. That is the second highest jam of the game. And as we were saying, that momentum pendulum does not know where it needs to be right now, because Dublin are playing a great game of the shorter jam, picking up the 4 points and cutting them down. But Antwerp have this fantastic ability to put on multiple scoring passes and hold Dublin scoreless thus far. And that has really been the difference and why the score is the way it is right now. So Dashing Trudy Snow versus Evil X. All the action in turn one, but there we see Evil X escape the front of the pack for lead for Antwerp.
Dash and Trudy Snow, star in hand. Just pushing against that two at the front. Now becomes a three with Dark Pistol dropping up the drain. Now Dark Pistol drops back again on the offense. As Dash and Trudy Snow finally through on the initial pass. Doesn't get the star back on before the jam is shut down. And it looks like we're getting an official review is going to be called.
Well, they are first of the game.
By Dublin. And we'll give a shout out to Powerdyne Plates and Skate Products, cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance. That's Powerdyne.
So we're in an official review right now, and the verdict of that will be delivered by our head ref. But just having a little chat. So this is Dublin's second Continental Cup. They finished second last time round when we were in the delightful Telford in the UK. But this right now is a post-season debut for Antwerp here in Helsinki.
Okay, so we're going to find out what the official review is being called for from our head referee, Bath, in just a second.
You might be able to pick up our house announcers doing a fabulous job in various languages.
Okay, here goes our.
So this is Dublin's official review. They're asking for a back block penalty on the pink jammer. Thank you.
Okay, so they're asking for a back block to be awarded to Evil X, that was, as the jammer for Antwerp. So obviously we'll get our officials, we'll discuss that. I'm not sure exactly which point in the jam the Dublin bench saw that infraction that they're asking for. But the speed at which Bob came in there makes me think that he was definite that he saw it.
So we're going to get the verdict any moment now.
So here comes the verdict from Bath.
After reviewing the situation, the contact was made to the side, not to the back, so the no call stands. Thank you.
Okay, so there we go. The official review verdict, the no call stands. The contact was to a legal contact or legal target zone on the skater.
I think that was a good, smart tactical choice by Dublin. You've only got 4.5 minutes left on the period, or the period half, so worth using it. Might have changed momentum, but as it is, hip shot is on the line and ready to go for Antwerp up against AK.
Hip shot. First time I've seen hip shot not being able to hold that line, hold the wheels on the rope.
That was Argy Bargy, who was making sure that hip shot couldn't get round, but then hip shot goes right back to the outside line and sneaks on by.
AK, however, is out with lead and is in a first scoring trip for Dublin.
Oh, and dropping Antwerp blockers beautifully. Hips around, 4 points for Dublin, 0 for Antwerp. So, penalty box is empty as we go into this next jam.
And we're now getting official review called from Antwerp.
I mean, if you don't use it, you're gonna lose it.
So. Exactly.
Let's ask some questions of our officials.
And instead of speculating, why don't we talk about the all-new Antic Jet Carbon, which is packed with features at a great price. Antic Jet Carbon Featherweight Performance. That's something that we know about, whereas this, we've got no idea.
I mean, you spoiled all my fun. I love to speculate.
Okay, so here comes Bath to tell us what it's actually for.
Antwerp's official review is about a cut on the blue jammer.
So Antwerp, they're looking for a cut call to be assessed against AK for Dublin.
Again, I didn't see where that might have happened, but...
Well, all the action seemed to be around turn 1-2, so it would be on the far side from us. But it would have been perfectly placed for the Antwerp bench to see it, which is maybe why we're getting the official review coming in.
Absolutely, very similar situation to the Dublin official review that just happened. So we've got 3 minutes and 53 left of this first period here in Helsinki at the Continental Cup. I'm just having a look, and the penalties have not racked up any more. The most any skater is sitting on right now is 3, and they are quite nicely spread across the teams. It's a total of 16 penalties for Dublin and 14 for Antwerp right now.
It looks like we're actually going to get the cut call assessed now to number 47. So Antwerp looked like they were successful with their official review, and so here comes Bath now just to confirm that.
As we see a vegan fox
after reviewing the situation, the cut will be assessed to the blue jammer. Antwerp retains the review.
One lost, 1-1.
Yeah, so Antwerp with the first successful official review of this European Continental Cup.
Evil X is on the line.
And Evil X with the power start now for Antwerp.
I can see... Titmash is hanging around on that inside line. And I have a feeling there we see the offense come straight in to try and clear that space. But right to the other side of the track goes Evil X. Just checks themselves and gets the no pass, no penalty to continue on.
I think Stabber for Dublin read that move and slid in to take the position that Evil X wanted to take up that inside line. However, Evil X is through now and is scoring for Dublin, with AK standing in the box, ready to come out the same now. Antwerp stretching the pack back on the penalty box straight as the penalty comes to an end. And AK is in. Lead is still available now if AK can get through this initial pass cleanly.
There it is. Well, that number 10 boot for Antwerp was playing some excellent offense, but immediately saw when AK was ready to come out of the box, and again, he's ready and waiting with a lovely braced tripod there. So 8 points on the board for Evil X already. AK grabs 4 for Dublin and then calls the jam. So 53 plays 93 right now. We're back to a 40-point game. 44, I think, is the largest the differential has been so far, but that is maths, so I could be wrong.
And let's face it, for us, it's early.
It's very early. Antwerp are doing a fantastic job of keeping the differential kind of 30 plus. But Dublin not giving up already, though. Dashing through the snow is deposited on the outside of the track by Cherry Moshpit, as we see Hipshot coming back in now on a scoring pass.
So that star pass was to Argy Bargy, however, the jam was called off before anything could be done with it.
So we're into the last minute and a half of this first half, Dublin versus Antwerp.
We've got a little discussion on the outside with the head referee, and we're going to go in. I thought we were going to have a quick official review there, official timeout, sorry, but we're getting back into the action straight away.
So it's Green Holcuni out there for Dublin right now, who is being recycled, but great awareness there to know where exactly they could come back on. And trying the same trick on the inside is Evil X, but penalty picked up by the Dublin blockers, and there are 2 in the box right now. Antwerp with just the 1 blocker in the box. That was a lovely little hug slash slide down to the floor there from Green Holcuni, who decides that getting back up is not advisable and calls the jam. 2 points picked up by Dublin in that one. And we maintain our 40-point differential. The largest it has been was that earlier moment in the game where it was 44 points.
And we've just got time to get one more jam in here.
One more jam. It's hip shot versus AK. Two in the box for Dublin, so the pack deficit is with them. But Hipshot having a time of things with that. Dublin 2-wall gets through and picks up lead now. AK doing battle. Little offensive support coming in from Dublin, but locked down in turn one.
Yeah, Antwerp have got the advantage with those two extra blockers, and they're making the most of that advantage.
Look at this defense from Antwerp, though. The progression only assisted by the offense that comes in. Though Antwerp have lost a blocker to the box. Oh, great hit. That was number eight.
That was Chancleta with that devastating hit on Hipshot.
That was beautiful. Yeah.
So just telling everyone in the arena here, I'm going to call this off in a minute, but just so you all know, it's coming.
And we are already into halftime. I can't believe how quickly that has gone. So we are into the half with 55 to Dublin Roller Derby, but 103 to Antwerp, which I'll be honest with you, I didn't expect. My bracket, if it continues this way, is in peril. I don't know how you are feeling about your brackets, but I am a little bit concerned because Antwerp have come out and they have done a number so far on the number one seed going into this.
Yep. It's always that kind of thing. You expect the number one versus the number eight seed to be fairly one-sided, but it's actually gone the other way. It's been one-sided a bit in favour of the number eight seed. So I'm sure Dublin are going to go to the locker room now and they're going to have a strong talk. It's one of the things that Bob is very well known for is his team talk. So if anybody can bring this back, it's going to be Dublin. So we're going to go to the half-time now. We're going to leave you with some words from our sponsors and we will be back in about 14 minutes or so with the second period of this game one from the European Continental Cup here in Helsinki, Finland. So please stick around and join us for that.
Hello and welcome back to Helsinki, Finland for the Continental Cup with the WFTDA. And oh, what a first half it was, Sven. So we are looking at Dublin sitting on 55, your number one seed, who are playing against Antwerp right now, who are the number eight seed, who are sitting on 103. So the story of the first half that you need to know about is that we had 25 jams, and so we had a lot of short jams, and Dublin were very much playing hit it and quit it derby, putting in the 4 points, calling it. However, Antwerp have managed 8 multiple point passes.
Yep.
As we go through. So that has been the real difference. So whereas Dublin are able to put up 4 points and call the jam, we've had 14s, 16s coming in from Antwerp. And that has really decided this big, big first half where we see quite the differential sitting in front of us. So I don't know about you, but as I mentioned before, I've got half an hour for my bracket to be redeemed by Dublin. But the defensive work of Antwerp has been fantastic.
Well, it's also been that, I mean, every time Dublin look like they're getting the momentum back, Antwerp just seem to find a new gear and break that momentum, just slow them down and again take it back. So we've seen a few runs of, like, it's been very back and forth with lead, with control. And I don't think that the power jams have only come into it a couple of times in terms of, like, dominating the track. I think one of the biggest jams we saw for Dublin was the result of a power jam with AK jamming. AK, of course, have been one of the kind of backup jammers for Dublin throughout the regular season, whereas one of Dublin's strongest jammers, Dash and Trudy Snow, who has been running a 3.05 points per jam average through the regular season, held to 4 points in this entire first period.
And the crazy thing is Dublin jammers are not doing badly at picking up leads. You know, we see we've got 75%, 87% in there for the Dublin jammers. You know, and actually, if we look at the Antwerp jammers, they're getting 60s, 50s, 56 in terms of lead percentage. So it doesn't really, the stats don't really show you what Antwerp are capable of putting up there once they do get lead. But for me, it's all about that multiple passes. And Dublin really need to find an answer to locking down these jammers in this second half if they want to close that gap.
Yeah, so the penalty stats, again, it's not really a case of Dublin are really penalty heavy. They're about equal, about 20-something penalties aside. There's only one player so far that's even looking close to penalty trouble, which is Snow Black for Antwerp, who's currently sitting on 4 penalties.
So we are having a power start for Dublin here. It's Greenhall Cooney as we see the Antwerp jammer in the box along with 2 blockers. So that was a lovely lead picked up by Dublin, relatively easy at the back there. And Dublin doing a great job of splitting up these blockers on track right now.
So Dublin will want to establish themselves early in this second period as we're getting some Antwerp blockers released. There's Snow Black now coming back to track. So just the Antwerp jammer waiting to come back, and that is Hipshot now coming to track, star in hand.
Snow Black, who have been goated, is actually now just deciding to be a useful goat and playing some offense as well.
The Greenall Cooney now coming up on his third scoring trip as Hipshot completes the first or the initial pass for Antwerp in this jam.
Dublin lose 1 blocker to the box at the end of that jam, so they will start with a pack deficit in the next jam. So this is what we saw from Dublin in the opening 2 jams of the first half. They came out strong. They put 2 jams down unanswered by Antwerp. So the second half may be starting as well. But 11 points, that is, as I said, a much needed multiple point pass. And that is their second of the game. So I think Dublin have switched on to some of the same things that we have, but it's AK versus Evil X right now.
Evil X just went for the sprint, but ended up on the knees in the middle of the pack, but gets through for lead for Antwerp. So again, we're seeing Antwerp now trying to break that start that Dublin got off to. Just being rolled off the track by Lana Payne, who picks up the forearm penalty in doing so. Evil X goes for the duke around Pippa, now taking the run around turn 2 as we have AK completing the initial pass, and Evil X shuts down the jam with another 4-point pickup.
So Dublin are going to need these multiple passes if they're going to close this differential down, whereas Antwerp can play Dublin's tactics of a very nice simple 4 points and call it.
So Lana Payne sitting in the box for Dublin as we get Dash and Trudy Snow standing about 15 feet back from the jam line. Hipshot with a 3 wall of pink in front.
And Snow Black is in there with the offense from the get-go. And it works beautifully to release Hipshot for lead. Dash and Trudy Snow, they're having a time of things right now. Only made it about 5 foot from the jam line so far with Antwerp locking down. Cherry Moshpit and Lieutenant Savage did an excellent job, but it looks like we do have a star pass for Dublin.
And that is Mania with the star now for Dublin.
Antwerp say, no, that'll do nicely. 8 points picked up, in fact. No, is that 12? Just gonna hold on. I got a little excited there. Let's see.
And we'll just give a shout out to S1 Helmets at s1helmets.com. The S1 Life Advisor Helmet, next level protection.
So it wasn't, that was just the 8 points picked up by Antwerp in that last jam. Evil X versus Greenhall Cooney, and Greenhall Cooney up the inside, driving through, takes the speed, toast up pirouette, and is your lead jammer.
And our in-house announcers are just giving us some feedback.
Right at the front of the pack, that is number 17, Dirty Knees Louise. Last line of defense for Dublin. But the pack, oh, a defensive jam in there from Greenhall Cooney just to try and deliver Evil X back into the blockers. Oh, but picks up a track cut for their efforts, and this is now a power jam in favor of Antwerp and Evil X. So, our lovely producer, Loud and Queer, has just informed me that this is going to be our first two-minute jam of the game. And a big shout out to Loud and Queer, who is providing us with all sorts of excellent facts and figures right here, right now, making Sven and I sound an awful lot smarter than we are.
Which is a lot smarter than we are. So we're getting our Lana Payne just rolling back. Evil X now being taken all the way back to the exit of turn two. Meanwhile, up the front of the pack,
Dark Pistol was the last line of defense there.
The green old Cooney is through, picks up four.
Antwerp are blocker goals, quite frankly.
CC Titmouse just gets rolled to the outside. And Greenhall Cooney is through again. Dublin just doing a great job, finally figuring out how you can hold up Evil X inside that pack. And only 3 points picked up by Evil X in that trip. Dublin capitalised slightly on that. Looks like they're going to go 12 points in the jam. 7 to Antwerp. Brings our score, Dublin 78, Antwerp 122, with 6 minutes of the second period played.
I was just having a little look at the penalties, and it appears like Dublin, who obviously have all the work to do, have picked up 4 penalties so far in this early stages of the second half, whereas Antwerp have kept it very clean so far. But look at AK, locked down again. It's 5-6 foot from the jam line, and AK is having to drive incredibly hard. And up front, the same is happening for the Antwerp blocker. Sorry, jammer. And that is hip shot. Hip shot, as I say it though, gets on through. Good old commentator's curse.
AK now out half a lap behind the pack. 3-on-3 in the pack right now, blocker-wise. And we're going to get a low block issued to Lieutenant Savage, which gives Dublin a slight advantage now going into this next jam. Antwerp, however, picking up 3 in that one.
So, yeah, Antwerp with 2 in the box, including their pivot. Dublin with just the 1 blocker in the box, as we see Vegan Fox head to the line, going up against Queen Yosin. Oh, and Dublin have actually just... Oh, is it we lost them? No, they just had too many. They were too excitable. So if we look at the score just on the second half, Dublin on 22, Antwerp on 23. So there's not a lot in it this second half, but of course Antwerp sitting on that differential from the first half, as we see Titmouse taking Vegan Fox right back.
And Vegan Fox picks up the cut track. CC Titmouse with a great move. Pushed Vegan Fox to the outside, then recycled, and Vegan Fox just came back on in front of another Antwerp block, and not CC Titmouse picks up the cut track though. So now Antwerp, Queen Yassine with the star in hand.
And Lowcock there making sure that with a big recycle.
So this will be another natural 2 minute jam. Obviously Queen Yassine had removed the helmet cover, so therefore not eligible for lead now.
But is now eligible for points.
Less than 10 seconds left on the power jam. Vegan Fox now released and returning to track. He's going to go the long way around though. Going to have to chase the pack about 3/4 of the lap of the track to get in here. We're going to generate some speed in doing that, and hits the back of the pack. Track inside, but is recycled by Lieutenant Savage.
Antwerp desperately trying to get Queen Yosin through. Number 85, Titmouse in there trying to offer the offense, but it's all crowded up on that back straightaway as we go into turn 3. Vegan Fox stays inbound, but number 10 is there once more. Majin Buu doing the work.
And that's a full 45-foot recycle there, pretty much from, you know, midway around turn 3 all the way back to turn 2. And now it's Lieutenant Savage takes Vegan Fox off the track. And it's Knick Mops that takes all the way back to turn 2.
Antwerp have this beautiful hammer and nail move. Oh my days, as I say that though, in comes number 8 once more. Changletta in exactly the same place as we saw it in the first half. Delivers the Antwerp jammer to the bench.
But then Knikmops decided Chancletter wasn't going to recycle the jammer and managed to put Chancletter down just before the jam came to an end.
So we had a two-minute jam. Do you know how many points they scored? 4. That's how good this defensive blocking has been so far.
And we've got full complement on track, all huddling the jam line, hip shot for Antwerp, dashing through the snow for Dublin. Hip shot though, with that speed through the middle.
That was a beautiful zigzag line there, just spreading the Dublin blockers across the track to get on through, but Greenhall Cooney only half a lap behind.
Knikmoff picks up the illegal contact penalty, so Antwerp one blocker short now. Quite a quick pack as we get hip shot calling off the jam. 2 points picked up by Antwerp.
So Dublin really have kind of come back in this second half, but they are up against this big differential. And unless they find a way to hold Antwerp down and scoreless, it does look like a big ask right now. But Evil X is on the line, up against AK, who was the biggest scoring jammer in the first half for Dublin.
Antwerp one blocker short as we get this jam underway. AK takes the advantage and ducks underneath Gunter, I believe that is. Sorry, underneath Dark Pistol to pick up a lead for Dublin. Evil X now, star in hand, just being railroaded off the inside of the trap by Lana Payne, held in place by Pippa and Dirty Knees Louise.
So AK again, AK put up the biggest scoring jam for Dublin in the first half and is looking to do the same here.
Takes a tumble around Dark Pistol, but back and running. Knikmops now comes back to track, bringing 4 and 4 in the pack.
We have a star pass for Antwerp now. That is going to number 10, Marjan Boom. But 8 points picked up by Dublin so far.
But wants to run this, so we're going to see it piled in.
And we see how pleased Marjan Boom was to come into that pack and pick up a very cheeky and easy line there.
Knikmops gets a affiliate reform penalty.
Oh, I'm sorry if I'm just making noise on your TV right now, but Marjan Boo with jammer skills delighting me, quite frankly.
So yeah, Lana Payne there managed to get the cut. So it was Pippa that knocked Marjan Boo from the track, but Lana Payne came all the way back right in front of us here on turn 4 and drew. And actually, no, it's been rescinded yet. Looks like Lana Payne maybe wasn't eligible for the cut.
Meantime, the jam continues, and AK has matched their first half score with 16 and has now gone past that with 20, which is the biggest jam of the game so far. Antwerp with 8 on the board. Marjan Boo is in there and trying to step on round, but can't. 5-7-5, Pippa takes them back. AK with 24. Now that is the kind of jam that Dublin absolutely need. We've got an official review, but I'm just going to continue to be just a little bit excited right now about the fact that Dublin just put up 24 points, their biggest jam. So there was a jam in the first half where AK went out, put up 16 points, and it doubled Dublin's score in that half. And AK's just done exactly the same here in this second half, Dublin's second half score. That is not as easy to say as you would think.
Something that is easy to say is Adam Skates, hashtag roll your way. That's adamskates.com.
We've got the official review going on right now. It's Dublin who have called that official review. Bob is in the middle, waiting.
Yeah, Violent Bob, VB, or Bob. Dublin's bench for as long as I can remember.
It's not broke, don't fix it.
And he came in very, very quickly, as soon as that jam ended. Again, I don't want to put my speculation hat on, but the only thing I could see in the jam there that was probably worth bringing up was why that cut was rescinded. Because obviously we did see the cut issue to Marjan Boo just in front of us here, when Lana Payne drew back. So I don't know whether the Bob's asking them to look at that again or if there's something completely different.
We will find out as Baff, our lovely head ref, will deliver that verdict to us from the middle. Just explaining things right now.
So, Did you know that the radar halo is now available in an 103A hardness? Are you kidding me? There is a halo for every service.
You find me a halo for my head, and I will give you a medal.
I mean, 103A, that's quite hard.
That is
hard. I will
say that. I'd like to be that hard.
I like to skate on wheels that are equivalent to a good bath sponge.
So, we're going to get hopefully the verdict delivered right now, but, and it does look like Dublin have reviewed it because I am watching AK sit themselves down in the box.
So, after reviewing two situations with the officials, both chambers will start in the box. Pink for a cut, blue for a back block. Thank you.
Okay, so there we go. So, we have to assume that Dublin asked for the cut on Margin Boo to be reassessed, which was successful. And as part of that as well, there was a discussion, probably just amongst the officials, about a back block on AK. Okay, so the word in the ear is that the official review is not being used because the officials are already going to discuss the situation. So Dublin won't be charged with this official review.
So you can't see it right now, but both jammers started this race from the box, side by side, and now they are back into the pack. It is AK, who looked like they were doing great, but is recycled. Evil X wearing the pivot right now for Antwerp, which is a very interesting situation. And doing some great blocking as well. Double threat, but does pick up a penalty for it.
Yeah, Evil X picks up the forearm penalty, so going to be sitting as the pivot. So if they were looking for a star pass from Margin Boo, that isn't going to happen within the next 30 seconds.
So AK is in and looking for room on the outside, but that is number 9, Gunter denying progress once more.
We've got a bit of a lockdown on this penalty box straight. Neither Jammer able to make any real headway. Dark Pistol just using those toe stops, letting themselves be slid backwards by AK, eventually having to be released, actually picking up an out of play penalty, I believe. Now AK is through, picks up 4 points on the pack.
So it looks like we have got the star pass now that Evil X is out of the box and now out of the pack as well. So AK has picked up another 4, so that is 8 points on the board for Dublin. They're going to run it. I can see the Dublin bench in the distance calling for them to run it. Oh, and that's a beautiful hit out there. That's number 95, Minia. And great confidence in the Dublin blockers. Sees AK go through to pick up 12.
AK really is now piling on the points for Dublin. Gets the call off, and we're going to see another 2 go up to a 14-point jam for AK.
And make sure that Antwerp only pick up the 1 scoring pass there, which is essential. So, AK, just casually, 38 points, picked up over 2 jams. And nice work if you can get it.
And that's brought the deficit down to some points. It's 145 to 116, which is probably, I don't know, 29 points. Is anyone good at maths?
If they're not round numbers, Sven, I'm not playing. So,
but we've still got half of the half left to go. We've still got half the period. There's 14:42 on the clock as we have a timeout called by Antwerp.
Which gives me the perfect opportunity to talk to you about Derby Without Borders. Check out derbywithoutborders.org to see how you can help support the growth of roller derby around the world. Please remember to bring your donation to 2019 Champs.
And we'll also give a shout out to Quick. So when you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick Bearings, where precision meets performance, and quick, in this case, is spelled K-W-I-K. So it's obviously very clever use of quick.
To see what they've done there.
Yeah. So all these obviously sponsors helping us bring you this amazing action here on the feed of this game. Still game 1, can you believe?
Honestly, if this the rest of the weekend's going to be like this, I am going to be exhausted. I absolutely am. So Dublin on 116, Antwerp on 145, and we've got 14 minutes and 42 seconds left of this game. is Hipshot versus Greenhall Coney.
Full complement, crowding the jam line at the moment. Hipshot goes for the quick line up the outside. Greenhall Cooney switches inside to outside, gets bounced to the outside off the track by Cherry Moshpit, forced all the way back to turn four.
That was unnecessary matrix moves there from Hipshot. The top half was out, the bottom half wasn't, and that's what counts as Hipshot goes through to pick up lead. And we have a star pass now for Dublin. That has gone to number 53, Argy Bargy.
So I think twice Argy Bargy's taken the star pass in the jams ended before Argy Bargy's had a chance to do anything with the star. So
if I was Argy Bargy, I'd say that's a compliment. The Antwerp are so terrified. They're like, quick, it's Argy Bargy, call the chair.
So we've got Evil X is going to line up again, 4-4 against Dash and Trudy Snow. Everyone crowding that jam line again.
So Evil X goes for the inside. Dash and Trudy Snow looking for the outside. They switches back across. But this pack has not even made it to the pivot line right now. Great blocking happening here. That was number 74 guarding the outside line. That was Stabber for Dublin.
It is tight in that pack right now. There's no way through for either jammer. As hard as the try.
Now, those of you who have been watching the Rugby World Cup will recognise that scrums look very similar to what we just saw there at the exit of turn one. But it is Dublin who come up with lead with dashing through the snow.
Evil X star in hand has been recycled now by Chancletta. Had the opportunity to seed the cut and now starts to move again, being held up in a three wall at the back though. Looks like Chancletta, Stabber, and I think that's Valdemort.
So we are back to this is one of the lowest differentials we've had. It is a 29 point game right now. And Dublin, who have put out Dashing Trudy Snow only for the second time in this half, and having a much better time of things right now. 8-0 in this jam. And Dublin look like they have figured out Evil X a little bit here.
Evil X just having all the speed taken away. And we're used to seeing Evil X being so dynamic, so quick, and just being locked down right now by the Dublin blockers at the back.
When you're playing quite a short rotation, if you've got an active jammer who clearly needs the speed and to get the lateral movement, it's got to be tough. And we do see the star pass now going across to number 10, Marjim Fu.
And if you heard the countdown from BB there, just letting Dash and Trudy Snow know the jam's going to come to an end, so we get a 3-point pass there.
And it is a 19-point game, so this is the lowest the differential has been, I think, since the second or third jam. And Dublin are not ready to quit. 11.5 left to go. My bracket takes a deep breath and hopes. But Antwerp are here, and they are ready to compete. It's AK versus Hipshot.
AK, of course, the main points holder for Dublin right now, just being held at the back by Lieutenant Savage, Cherry Moshpit.
Yeah, that three wall because Snow Black is up front doing the offensive work, but through comes AK for lead for Dublin. I mean, AK was the most successful jammer in the first half for Dublin, and that trend has continued, I believe, into this second half, but Hipshot is right behind.
And two blockers from Antwerp. So it was Cherry Moshpit picked up a multiplayer block, which is what let AK get through to pick up lead.
Pretty sure.
Dublin are going to start off here with the pack advantage, and they're going to be putting Greenall Cooney out. No, they're not. Sorry, they're switching over Vegan Fox.
And I think that was our very first scoreless jam of the entire game so far. This is very exciting. Oh, no. Point. Nope. I was right. Check me out. For once, I was right. Queen yourself is struggling and has actually lost 2 foot from the jam line right here with Dublin, who's sucking up the space. Vegan Fox pushing out front, one to beat. And does so. And in fact, the Antwerp blocker goes to the box. Antwerp with three in the box right now.
stuff past the margin boo.
Vegan Fox. Oh, lovely dip round the outside of just the one. Antwerp Bocker calls it. And Antwerp were very lucky there. Their one blocker just released at the end of that jam, so it's one apiece.
So there was two. No, yeah, there's two blockers released for Antwerp right near the end of the jam. So it does bring them back to actually having more than one blocker on track. 3-on-3 as we get Greenall Cooney lining against Hipshot for this next jam. Under 10 minutes now remaining.
And Dublin within 15 points of Antwerp. So Greenall Cooney is struggling at the back, but just slips around the hips in a beautiful move to pick up lead for Dublin. Hipshot is well aware of the danger here, puts on the burners and chases that pack down. Oh, a lovely little hop up the inside there from Greenall Cooney. It doesn't have to be big. It doesn't have to be spectacular. It just has to be efficient.
Looks like we're going to get a timeout straight away from Dublin, stopping the clock.
Antwerp managed to sneak 2 points in on that jam.
So it says official timeout on your screen, but it looks like it was a team timeout that was called by Dublin. So Dublin are almost outscoring Antwerp, 2-1 in this second period. Dublin scoring 86 points.
So Dublin just assessing their jammer options. Greenall Cooney comes off and AK jumps on instead, ready for this next jam.
Okay, so we've got AK, Evil X, 3-on-3 blockers. Dublin currently sitting holding the back three, ready to hopefully catch Evil X.
It's a 13-point game right now. And I hope the tension levels are suitably raised with you as they are with us. And Evil X goes for the outside line and is shut down.
Great hit from Mania just to catch Evil X as they went for the outside line there.
AK having similar lack of success on that outside line and is recycled by Majin Boo. Evil X pushing out up front, almost at the exit of turn two right now. But Dublin doing everything they can to avoid the offense that is being offered. And locking down on Evil X. And that has been the key, I think, in this second half. But there we go, Evil X picks up lead for Antwerp. So we have a star pass for Dublin. Stabber has taken the star. Tries to slow Evil X down on the way through, but cannot do it. And once Evil X has put that speed on Sven, very difficult to stop.
Yeah, these Antwerp jammers, especially Hipshot and Evil X, have just shown how agile they are, especially at holding the balance in the spins. You know, one foot on the outside lines. I think that's when they can get that speed, they can use it well, but as we've seen, if Dublin can shut that speed down, they do seem to then struggle a bit.
Yeah, if they get the catch, the containment follows beautifully. And again, Evil X, just that lateral movement across the track, but yes, goes through Stabber. That looked like incredibly hard work to get on through and complete the initial. And Antwerp, a great jam just to try and take this game a bit further out of the reach of Dublin.
Dublin using another team timeout. So we will give a shout out to S1 Helmets. So the WFTDA would like to thank S1 Helmets. And while we're talking about S1 Helmets, we'll tell you about S1Helmets.com. The durable, functional, stable, the S1 Pro knee pads are built for roller derby.
Unlike me, I'm not built for roller derby. Pretty much built for talking about it, though. And there are some people out on track right now who are built for it. Hipshot has been a fantastic jammer in this game for Antwerp, up against Greenall Cooney for this next jam.
Oh.
more excellent stats coming in from our fabulous producer, Loud and Queer, just letting us know that Dublin have been held scoreless 8 times in this second half, whereas Antwerp have only been held scoreless 4 times. So we're going into this last 7 minutes and everything that to play for here. One on the outside.
Lana Payne with the move, Pippa with the recycle, and then they go back and catch. Hip shot. Again, just trying to take hip shot speed, but hip shot's very quick on the toe stops, going left to right.
Green Hawkeye at the front there, just desperately looking back over the shoulder to see if there was any possibility of offense coming in, but at the time their pivot was having to bridge. Oh, and bouncing straight off the pivot of Dublin was the Antwerp jammer hip shot.
And we've got lead for Green Hawkeye, but hip shot closing the gap down to about 10 feet on the track. 3-on-3 on the pack, rolling out of this crowd straight. Both jammers are going to hit the pack around at the same time, but Dublin have the back wall and they capture hip shot.
Green Hawkeye jumped around the outside of turn one there. That was outrageous and awesome at the same time. Goes back through, pushing up. Only a 2 wall for Antwerp right now, as we've got number 7 in there. Cherry Moshpit trying to play offense and set hip shot free.
Penalty box empties now. Marjan Boo comes on, tries to open up some gaps on the offense for hip shot, but hip shot just being captured again.
We just stop for a moment. Everybody takes a breath and assesses their options at the exit of turn one. And it is quite the melee up there. Now we see the packs separate into distinctive formations. Hip shot. Might be a bit tired at this point. Locked in at the back of Dublin. Looks for the offense. As we see Green Hawkeye pushing hard up front and does, in fact, escape for 4. Just in the nick of time there.
3 points picked up by hip shot. So it's going to be 12-3 point jam. Just waiting for the receivers.
We are back to a 20 point difference. So Antwerp just giving themselves a little bit of space there. We were down to 13 points at one point.
So it was an 8-3 point jam. So the 4 points I could see were still being reported in for the second pass, second trip.
Dashing through the snow versus Evil X. Dashing through the snow, recycle, has to go back behind the jam line and start again.
Mania gets Evil X off the track, takes Evil X back to turn 4.
Oh, great shirt whip and a hop there from Evil X to just stay in bounds magically. And picks up lead for Antwerp. And as you might be able to hear here, the Antwerp fans love that, and they are very excited as we head into these final 4 minutes. We've got Pippa. Is it Pippa out jamming right now? But it is a power jam for Dublin. Forearm picked up by Evil X there.
It's Stabber that's taken the star number 74 for Dublin.
And having a time of things on that penalty box straight away. It is recycled, but Dublin shut the gate. So Evil X has only picked up 2 penalties in this entire game so far. Both of those have been forearms. Oh, Matrix moments there from Stabber. Number 85, Titmouse, was looking to hammer that point home, but wasn't able to. Evil X out of the box now.
If I'm right, this is the first time we've seen Stabber with the jammer star in the game, obviously taken as a result of the star pass. So the first points we're going to see on the board for Stabber.
I don't want to correct you. I feel like Stabber had a go earlier, but I could be wrong. I could be wrong. But right now, Dublin doing an excellent job of locking down Evil X at the exit of turn 4. The offense is coming in.
No, it is confirmed. It's Stabber's first time.
Sven's right. What you need to know is Sven's right, and I should remember that.
On this occasion, I was correct.
Take it. So as we head into the last 2 minutes and 42 seconds, we're having an official timeout. It is 149 to Dublin. It plays 170 to Antwerp, which makes it a 21-point game. So Dublin got within 13 points of Antwerp in this second half. Antwerp have just managed to control the game as we head into these closing stages. But AK is on the line. If you've got an AK in your arsenal, now is the time to use it if you are Dublin.
And the 2019 WFTDA playoffs are brought to you by the popular Rydell Solaris. Solaris, the performance you demand, the comfort you've been missing. Well, there's a hush on the crowd there, isn't there?
Was. Yeah, the tension has absolutely built here. But let me just tell you about Antique Skate. The all-new Antique Jet Carbon is packed with features at a great price. Antique Jet Carbon Featherweight Performance.
And as I keep saying, this is still only game number one of this European Continental Cup in Helsinki, Finland.
I feel like you guys are going to need to rest and hydrate just as much as we are, because this is going to be a fantastic weekend of derby if this game is anything to go by. Ooh, we've got a musical crowd in today. So, if you want to stay tuned today, our next game up at 11 a.m. is Perth Roller Derby versus Old Reiki Roller Derby. Game 3 at 1 is Central City Roller Derby versus Kallio Rolling Rainbow, who are our fabulous hosts for this wonderful Continental Cup. And game 3 is Tiger Bay Brawlers versus Dock City Rollers. Those of you who are, you know, into Twitch and like to join us on the Twitch stream, game 5 will be brought to you on Twitch today. And that will be the loser of this game versus the loser of game 2.
So we're getting ready to go back to the next jam. As I said, hip shot and AK. All blockers accounted for at the moment. Hip shot goes for the outside line, picks up the outside line, and picks up lead for Antwerp as we get CC Titmouse just gets AK rolled all the way back to the jam line.
So hip shot is in now, looking for points, picks a beautiful line, slaloms through the Dublin pack, who just couldn't stay together there. But AK is still having trouble, hasn't made it past turn one yet. Hip shot on a second scoring pass. And I don't want to be a pessimist, but this might just be a closeout. But as I say that, hip shot taken back, has to recycle as AK comes in on a first scoring pass.
So AK picks up 2 points before the call-off. So Antwerp still outscoring Dublin, but Dublin's still being allowed to get some points on the board. Less than 2 minutes remaining in the game. Dublin have no timeouts, but they do have an official review. So Dublin have got an opportunity to stop the clock at least once.
It's Evil X for Antwerp versus Green Horcuni for Dublin. The penalty box is empty. There's a full complement of blockers on track. And the tension in here is immense right now, as we see the number 8 seed potentially beating the number 1 seed in the first game. There is a cut track being called.
It's on Valdemort, number 3 for Dublin as a blocker.
But Dublin have not come up with lead. It is a track cut, and that is heartbreak for Green Horcuni, who skates past us.
Lead is still available because the cut track happened before the lead was technically awarded.
So Evil X could still be lead jammer. We are down to 45 seconds on the period clock. And Dublin blockers, though, absolutely locking this down. They do not want to let Evil X through, but commentator's curse sees Evil X immediately out to pick up lead. And the first upset of the weekend is on the card, Sven.
Well, if Antwerp run this jam now, and if Evil X can steer clean, that's the game locked
up.
There won't be an opportunity for Dublin to stop the clock to get an extra jam. So all they've got to do is basically keep Evil X out there, keep this jam running.
Oh.
And they've got the first upset of the weekend.
Marjimbo, a huge part of that blocking dynasty that Antwerp have displayed today. Just constantly there to hammer Greenhall, Coney. But Evilex locked down, but just knows they have to stay clean, stay tidy, and the period clock is dead now. And that, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, humans of all varieties, is a massive upset right here at the WFTDA 2019 Continental Cup being held here in Helsinki, Finland. Antwerp roller derby, your one love roller dolls, came in number 8 seed, and they have just disposed of the number 1 seed Dublin roller derby.
Yep. Number 65 ranking WFTDA versus number 31 ranking WFTDA, and we get an upset like that. What a game it's been all the way through, but what a game Antwerp have played.
Dear Antwerp, I would like you to apologise on Twitter to everybody's brackets that you have ruined in a beautiful fashion. Okay, we are all heartbroken, but wonderfully pleased at the same time. I really hope, Sven, that the rest of the weekend lives up to this kind of game. So, those of you who are big fans of Dublin, though, means you get an opportunity to catch them later on Twitch.
Yep. And I believe you will be.
I will be there.
So
I will be there.
You
join
will have
me.
A chance to call Dublin again on Twitch later on. That's game 5 this afternoon.
Don't go anywhere though, because coming up at 11 a.m. it's Perth roller derby versus Old Reeky roller derby, and that also promises to be a tasty one. Perth coming all the way from Australia, Old Reeky from Scotland. Let's see how that one goes.
Yeah, and if it's anything like this, I'm gonna have to go and see if they've got more defibrillators on standby. Because the way this game has gone, I do need to have a lie down.
But let's do that, Sven.
Yep,
let's get out of here.
So thank you very much. I've been Sven.
I've been Riggs.
And we've had Loud and Clear just out of shot there, giving us all a cool info. So that was game 1 of the European Continental Cup here from Helsinki, Finland. Stick around for game 2, as I say, Perth Roller Derby versus Old Reeky Roller Derby coming up very soon.